In the prior video, we created this custom outcome harvesting object from a CSV spreadsheet using the Lightning Object Creator. And this was the spreadsheet we used. And again, remember, these are the records that we're pulling in information. You can see here, these are the records which resulted in these records, which actually allowed us, if we went out and took a peek, to be able to go and see this field, which created a multi-select pick list of those field values. But what we're recognizing is that this is a rather cumbersome record, and that there are so many fields here that we have to look at, and they're all just basically streaming through it. So it's very hard to process. If you recall, we were working from a basic spreadsheet. This was just a brainstorm. Again, I'm not an outcome harvesting practitioner, but there's a bunch of different fields that we brought in. We also had some sections that we could pull in. What would it mean to add those sections? If we look at this record, what we're able to do is to go here. We can either edit this page, or we can edit the object and add the page. But let's go ahead and edit the page just to show you how that's going to look. Editing the page takes us to this Lightning App Builder. We can close this one, which is just a help screen. What we want to do is to select this screen here, which is the outcome details. And it shows us that we're previewing this. We can click here and take a look. And we find ourselves looking at the outcome harvesting page layout. And again, we're in the object manager. We would have also gotten there had we come in this way and gone to edit the object. It would have taken us to the same place. Scrolling down in the record, we get this information, which is all just basically streamed. So what we want to do is to create a section. And so we currently have an outcome details section. Looking back at our initial suggestions, we had one here we called description of the change. So let's go add that. So we can click here, and we can drag in a section here and call it description of the change. We're going to drop it for now, and we're going to say description of a change. These are some selections. Again, you can read more about this. This is just section properties on page layouts. Now, these sections, we can rename them. We can move them around. So I'm just going to move these up here into the outcome section. And I'm going to say, great, let's just add these. And this is an out. Let's just add it over here as a second field. Let's put outcome summaries here. Now, then we have a description of the change. And then the next section would be significance of the change after the unexpected change. So let's just drop that in. So I can move these around, and I can say, okay, these I actually want in description, so I'm going to move these up here, the who, what, when, where. These we can add any number of places again, but we're just kind of moving them around just to get a sense of what kinds of groupings are going to make sense. And I can add them where I'd like to. So after adding sections, you know, here's a good starting point. Yours can look different. Again, you don't have to pull all these fields in. You can choose not to use them. So if you take and you add this up here, you can see that it'll drop in here and you no longer have it on your layout. Still available as a field, you can pull it back in. We have these other categories of change that we could be looking at, and we'll go with several different sections. Let's take a look at how that looks. So we're going to click save, and going back out to our record, we can now refresh this page. And we now have many sections that we can work from. This is a description, obviously. We can close this. And the significance of the change, the contribution summary. the source, where it came from, substantiation, substantiation levels, lots of different information that we can bring into this. By adding sections, it should give you a little more clarity in terms of being able to organize information and figure out what's valuable to you and to the information that you'd like to capture. And we can talk in the next videos, it'll be about how we can work with the compact layout, how we can work with required fields and data sensitivity, adding help text, other features to make it effective and easy to use this system.